What's up, Taurus? Love forecast for you guys for what's coming in the first 2 weeks of June. That's June 1st through to the 15th. This is for my Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, and for the cross-watchers. If you guys enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give me a like and throw me a comment. And if you're new to my channel, I put these out every 2 weeks, so don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you can keep up with me as I do. Also, guys, I do offer personal readings, and all the info for that is in the description box of the video. Okay, let's get started. Spirit, what's coming in, please, for my Taurus, Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus in the first 2 weeks of June? Any love messages for Taurus, Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, first 2 weeks of June? What can you tell my Taurus, Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus is coming in for them in the first 2 weeks of June in the area of love? Okay, feels good, guys. Chariot card, Four of Wands, Tower, Queen of Wands, Page of Cups. Ooh, Taurus, someone's coming in with a love offer for you that is going to shock you, okay? I've got the Tower card, the Chariot card, and the Four of Wands here with the Page of Cups. This is a loving offer, and this is someone that's seeing you as very sexy. You're coming across as quite magnetic here, okay? With the Tower card, this is something that's going to shock and surprise you, and the Four of Wands really is about someone seeing you very much for the long term. This is something moving very much in the direction of your favor, okay? With the Chariot card, this is positive movement forward for a particular connection. This Page of Cups here, he's seeing you as someone that he wants to build with for the long term. Let's get a little bit more on this Four of Wands. This is a focus on stability, and the Judgment card, yes. So for some of you, this is a comeback around from a person where things might have fallen apart. This person could have had an aha moment. Okay, and the Judgment card to me is like a comeback around and an awakening, and someone that really wants to, like I said, have positive movement forward. For this person, they may live at a distance from you. That's just for some of you with that Chariot card, or this is a person really traveling towards you. Okay, they might be just getting in the car to come and see you, or just wanting to move ahead. They want this connection to move forward because the Knight of Cups is here. Knight of Cups is someone coming in wanting to be romantic, wanting to be loving towards you. And the Six of Pentacles is them wanting to be generous with you, okay? Perhaps they weren't so generous before with their time, with their energy, etc. But it's like they're really seeing you as someone that they're fired up to move towards, okay? With the Knight of Pentacles and the Moon, things could have been quite slow with this person. This is like slow and steady energy. With the Knight of Pentacles, you know, maybe this person kind of takes their time, or was taking their time. And with the Moon, you know, it's like maybe you felt like this person was keeping you in the dark, or maybe there's a sense of things not being totally clear, all right? This person also might have some hidden fears, etc., that slowed the connection down, and maybe that's why you felt like this wasn't moving, or you felt like this person wasn't serious, okay? But this is someone, like I said, I feel like they're going to shock you when they come in, okay? With the Magician card and the King of Pentacles and the Hermit card, I feel like this person's been doing some heavy soul searching, okay? You could have also, Taurus, because I feel like maybe you've taken some time out to do some soul searching with that Hermit card. Maybe you're taking emotional distance from this person because you're trying to work out what's the wise decision for the long term. And maybe you've been trying to manifest things elsewhere with the Magician card, thinking about how you can create the best future for you. Queen of Wands to me, like I said, you're coming across as very sexy, so maybe you do have a number of choices or options, and you know, you're very independent, right? Queen of Wands, very with or without you energy. But we've got the Two of Wands here, so this is you being at a crossroads. So I do feel like, Taurus, you do kind of have a connection with this person, and you do kind of, you might be hanging on still a little bit with them, even though they've been taking their time. And you know, they're weighing heavy on your mind with the Ten of Wands, but I also feel like there's some burdens connected to this person, okay? And it's been keeping the connection stuck. Hangman. Hangman is like one foot in, one foot out. It's also a sense of some kind of a sacrifice needing to be made to move ahead, to end the burdensome cycle. I think for some of you, you have other energies around. Five of Wands. You could have other options, as I said, or Five of Wands, there could have been other energies that were interfering with your connection with this person. Maybe they have some other people around, okay? With the Fool card, it's like you're ready to take a leap onto something new, as I said. Taurus, Eight of Cups, you could have decided you're going to turn your back on this person, okay? But I did say that they want to come in, they want to give you an offer, because Two of Cups and the Lovers card and the Ace of Cups and the Eight of Wands. Okay, this person definitely feels like there's a strong connection with you, okay? But this is also choices and decisions, duality. You could be in a bit of duality about this person, because maybe you just think it's not going anywhere, or maybe you're choosing between a couple of people. But Eight of Wands means quick movement forward for a new love beginning, okay, and communication. So I do feel like, yeah, a decision is going to need to be made for you, Taurus. But someone's advancing quite quickly towards you and they want to like have a new love beginning or renew the love with you, okay? I'm going to get a couple of cards specifically on this person. Some of the signs that we have, we've got Virgo, Gemini energy with the Magician. We've got Scorpio. We've got Cancer energy, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. We've got Aquarius. And we've got Wands, so Aries, Leo, Sag, guys. Oh, and we've got Pisces, Cancer with the Moon. Okay. Let's see. So what is this person on Taurus's mind? How are they feeling about Taurus? What are their feelings and intentions for Taurus right now? Okay. Queen of Pentacles, Five of Swords, Seven of Pentacles, Seven of Swords, Hanged Man, Ace of Swords, Two of Pentacles. Oh, Taurus, I see. Okay, so Queen of Pentacles. So you are coming up as the Queen of Pentacles in your own read. That's the way they see you. They see you as someone that's very grounded, very nurturing, also someone that they want to settle down with. You're like a good choice for the long term. There's definitely been some stuff that's interfering with this connection. They're feeling like it's almost like they were trying to get away with something, Taurus, with the Seven of Swords. And the Ace of Swords is like having, you know, wanting to come clean, wanting to come forward and communicate. So I do feel like this person wants to talk. They want to say something to you. If you feel like things were hidden with the Moon card, it's like they want to clarify things. And the Two of Pentacles means they could have been juggling more than one choice or option, or maybe they feel now you're juggling more than one choice or option, okay? Seven of Pentacles means they have a foundation with you. It's like things didn't come to fruition in the way that you guys wanted, because the Hanged Man, which is the energy you guys are in as well, is that, you know, things are kind of stuck. It's like they've got one foot in and one foot out. With the Hierophant card and the Four of Pentacles, though, it's like they're still holding on to you, Taurus, and they're seeing you as someone that they could commit to, okay? The Hierophant card is marriage, long-term traditional values, and that's you showing up in your own read. They have stress around it. Why? Because the Moon. Guys, I told you this person has some fears or some things going on in the background that maybe you don't know about. And I think maybe they want to come clean about that, okay? Because the King of Wands and the Tower, they're going to take action towards you and it's going to surprise you, okay? King of Wands, you could be dealing with an Aries, Leo, Sag, Masculine, and the Tower card. So we've got, you know, double tower energy here, guys. So this person is going to take some action that's going to shock and surprise you, okay? Interesting. So Eight of Swords, it's like they've been feeling very trapped in their mind. I feel like this person thinks about you quite a lot. And the Knight of Swords to me means they want to charge in. They want to charge in and communicate. They also might want to be cutting away some things that have been interfering. And like I said, they also want to probably communicate some stuff to you, maybe speak their truth and clarify things. But I feel like, Taurus, you've got choices and options here, as I said, and I think you will need to make a decision with the heart in the first 2 weeks of June. That lover's card is often making decisions with the heart. And I do feel like, Taurus, you're in the process of kind of walking away from this anyway to jump onto something new with the Fool card. So decide what you really want when this comes at you, okay? What's this? Very soon. Guys, did you hear what I said? Decide what you want. So the romance angel, clearly decide what you want so that it comes to you now. There you go. So you need to make a decision about what you really want, Taurus, okay? Let your friends help you. Ask for and accept support from others, okay? So you could be seeking support from friends, or you might just be like going out a lot with friends and having a good time, okay? True love. This is the romance of a lifetime. So I think regardless, Taurus, you've got true love coming at you. So you don't need to worry too much. And religious factors, your love life is influenced by your religious upbringing and spiritual path. Well, for some of you that may apply, you may have a different background to this particular person, and that could be what causes conflict, you know, or maybe, you know, you're more spiritual than this person, for example. So that could be a factor. Or maybe it's a very spiritual connection. Lover's card can sort of be that very soulful spiritual connection. Keep an open mind. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. Interesting. So for some of you, there are a lot of differences between you and this person, but it's important to keep an open mind. Or you have choices and options. You have something new coming at you, because I do have new love. Okay, you have something new coming at you that's maybe not what you would expect, or it's different to your usual type, but it could be that true love. And give your relationship a chance. So either you need to give someone in front of you a chance, or this person coming back They want to work on things and spirit's saying to give it a chance. You guys will know intuitively what's right for you. I don't tell you what to do, okay? All right, Taurus, I'm going to leave it at that and I hope that it resonated for you. And if so, you can give me a like and a comment and I will check in with you in 2 weeks' time. Lots of love.